Good evening, children. Welcome to revision class 4. What do animals eat? All animals need food in order to live and grow. Why animals need food? To grow and live, all animals need food. We may observe the figures. Not only that, all animals need food to live and grow. No matter where an animal lives, finding food is an important work. It must do in order to survive. However, different animals differ in the food they eat. We may observe that different animals eat different food. They also differ in the way they get their food. They obtain their food from plants and animals. How do animals get their food? They get their food from animals and plants. Food can be defined as anything solid or liquid. What is food? Food can be defined as anything solid or liquid, which, when swallowed, digested, and assimilated in the body, provides it with essential substances called nutrients and keeps it well. It is the basic necessity of life. Food supplies energy, enables growth and repair of tissues and organs. It also protects the body from disease and regulates body functions. What is the use of the food? The food keeps us health, and it supplies energy and enables growth and repair of tissue and organs. It also protects the body from diseases and regulates body function. There are 5 basic food groups suggested by Indian Council of Medical Research, ICMR. These include cereals, grains and products, pulses and legumes, milk, meat products, fruits and vegetables, fats and sugars. These are 5 basic groups suggested by Indian Council of Medical Research. We may observe the figures, the grains. What is present in the grains? What gives us the grains? Grain gives us the energy. All the grains, rice, bajra, wheat, jawar, ragi, also called as grains. These grains are carbohydrates. It provides energy to do work. When we observe, it is also carbohydrates or starches are energy giving food, and then proteins. We may observe the proteins, milk, meat, fish, and pulses are known as proteins. It is also give us the is help us to growth of the body depend on the protein. So proteins is also very, very necessary to eat. The third item is fats. Where it is contained, the fats contains in all the food, burgers, pizzas, and etc. It is also causes damage to ill health. It is contain more energy. If you work more hard, you take it. Otherwise, it will be stored in our stomach. When you observe the fourth one, that is vegetables. Fruits and vegetables give us healthy food. So everyone should eat fruits and vegetables are healthy food. Harish.
మన ఇంగ్లీష్ కావాలి
Okay, children, the ICMR, there are five basic food groups suggested by Indian Council of Medical Research, ICMR. These includes cereals, grains and grain products, pulses and legumes, milk and meat products, fruits and vegetables, fats and sugars. We may already know about the grains. Grains also known as the energy-giving food. The milk meat is also known as proteins. Proteins give us the growth. It will be helped to grow the fats. Fats is also helped to growth. It causes constipation, indigestion. When you eat more fats like burgers and pizzas, what is the good food? Only the vegetables and fruits are good food to eat. Why do animals need food? Like humans, animals also need food to gain energy for their cellular metabolism and other body functions. Animals have a wide variety of metabolisms for which they need food, which is converted into energy and is used in two different forms of metabolism. Metabolism is the process by which your body converts what you eat and drink into energy. Are you understand metabolism? Metabolism is the process by which your body converts what you eat and drink into energy is called metabolism. Here the animals eat. The cow is eating the grass. This in the metabolism of eating grass, it converts to energy. In the figure second, the butterfly collects the nectar from the flowers. It is the nectar is converted into energy in the butterfly. In squirrel, the fruits, what they eat? They eat the fruits and nuts. The fruits is converted by the metabolism, it converted into energy. Here is the figure. The hummingbird. The hummingbird is swallow and long beak. With the help of this beak, it collects the nectar from the flowers and take it. By the metabolism of the nectar, it gets energy. In the last figure, the cheetah. Cheetah it collects its food as animal. In the process of digestion, metabolism, the food is converted into energy. Food habits of different animals. The different animals have different food habits. Every animal has its own food habit. For example, sparrow eat sparrow. What they eat? They eat worms and grains. How they find the food by the sparrows? By looking and searching. Next example is dog. Dog collects its food, bones and bread. How they find the food by the dog? By sniffing, the dogs find their food. Cat is a cat eats meat and milk. How they find the food? The cat find their food by smell and seeing. Smell and seeing, cat will find its food. Cheetah. What they eat cheetah? Cheetah eat meat. How they collect the food? They collect their food by hunting and searching. Buffalo. What they eat buffalo? Buffalo eat grass. How they collect? They collect its food by find its food by seeing and looking. Eagles. What they eat eagle? Eagle eat mammals and birds. How they find food? The eagle can find food by seeing and hunting. Tiger. What they eat tiger? The tiger eat meat only. How they find food? They find food by hunting. Goat. What they eat goat? Goat eat grass, herbs. How they find food? They find food looking and seeing. Next is fish. What is the food? What they eat? Fish eat worms and snails. How they find food? By seeing. In giraffe, what they eat giraffe? Giraffe eats plants and trees. How they find food? They find food by looking. Crow. What they eat? Crows eat dead animals and grains. How they find food? Flying and observing, the crow will find their food. Butterfly. How the butterfly? What is the food of butterfly? The butterfly collects its food from the flowers is nectar. By sucking method. It collects, butterfly collects its food by sucking, its food is nectar. By how the butterfly find food? Flying and looking. Duck. What they eat duck? Duck eat fish, fishes and worms. How they find food by ducks? Looking and seeing. Hen. What they eat? Hen eats insects and grains. How they find food? Hens can find their food by looking and searching. Sheep. What the sheep eat? The sheep eats grass. How they find their food? By seeing and looking. Frog. How the frog? What is the food of frog? Insects. How they find food? The frog can find food by looking. Hummingbird. What they eat? Hummingbird. The hummingbird collects nectar with swallow beak. How they find food? The hummingbird may find their food by flying and searching. Elephant. What they eat? Elephant. Elephant eat trees and sugars, sugar cane. Elephant eat trees and sugar cane. How they find food? The elephant find food by looking and seeing. We may observe that different animals, dog may find its mouth parts are suitable for getting its food. The mouth parts are tearing teeth, biting teeth, and chewing teeth are present in the mouth. The tearing of flesh is well suited for dog. And the paw has sharp claws to tear the flesh of animals. When you find the giraffe have a long neck to reach the branches to collect its food. When you observe the tiger paw have sharp claws and it have energy to run to hunt the animals, and it the teeth is also well suited for hunting the animals, to tear the flesh of animals, to kill the animals. These are the conditions to suitable for every animal to getting the food. When you observe cheetah, it runs fast. It is also hunting animal. It eats meat. Its body parts are used to collect the food. When you observe a goat, goat eats the grass only. By the metabolism of the grass, it collects the energy. When you observe the buffaloes also collects its food as grass. Here we observe the eagle. Eagle is also flying high. Its eye power, vision power is well developed, and its sharp beak is curved beak and sharp claws are to collect the prey or food. The body parts are useful to collect its food. In eagles, the vision power is well developed. Here we observe the bird. It also sharp beak. It collects its food by removing the upper layer of the grains. Elephant have a long trunk to collect the food, and the hummingbird is also collects its food from the flowers too. And cock is also, the different body parts are helpful to collect its food. When you observe the tiger's mouth parts are very suitable, and its teeth also sharp to tear the flesh of animals. Here is a small bird, that is the butterfly. It have a trunk. With the help of trunk, it collects the nectar from the flowers. Nectar is the food for the butterflies. When you observe the sheep is also eat the grass. By the metabolism of the grass, it gets its energy. When you observe, here is the duck. What is the food of duck? The duck have long beak. The beak is look like a comb. The beak is only useful to catch the food, and it is not biting, for only it is, the teeth is useful to use as filters to remove the water from the food. When you observe the frog is also collects, it has throws the, it eats the prey by throwing sticky tongue from the insect, and it is collects the food. When you observe the fish is also collects its food, and it is swallow the food. The teeth is not useful to grind, biting the prey. Which of the animals listed by you eat nearly the same food type of food? Deer, rabbit, goat, sheep, elephant, giraffe, buffalo. All these animals commonly eat grass. What are the types of food that your pet animals eat? Dog will eat bones and bread. Cat will eat meat and food grains. Class na listening. Write about two animals in your list describing the type of food they eat and how they get their food. Sparrow and hen will eat worms and grains, and they get their food by looking and seeing. The animals also two types, domestic animals and wild animals. The animals which live in the forest are known as wild animals. The animals which live in our houses are known as, commonly known as, the domestic animals. The domestic animals mostly herbivores. The wild animals are mostly carnivores. The food chain includes many different kinds of animals, all of which have specific food they eat. Three different types of animals exist. They are herbivores, omnivores, carnivores. Herbivores means some animals eat only plants, making them herbivores. Often herbivores concentrate their food munching on just the fruits and seeds of plants, ignoring stems, leaves, and roots. Herbivores have specific digestive tracts that are designed to handle different types of plants they might eat. Herbivores usually have big front teeth called incisors. These teeth are used to grasp and cut plants. Herbivores also have molars in the back, which they use to grind up the plants in their mouths. Herbivores are often large animals such as cow, deer, and elk. As you might imagine, it takes a lot of food to give a large herbivore the energy it needs. That is why herbivores may spend a large part of their day eating. Herbivores can also be medium-sized animals such as sheep or goats. Examples of small herbivores include squirrels and chipmunks. Herbivores need a lot of food to satisfy their hunger. We may observe the different herbivores: cow, sheep, deer, horse, gorilla, tortoise, and the lion. So many animals are herbivores. The animals eat only grass, or plants are known as herbivores. Herbivores are also known as plant-eating animals. The plant-eating animals are known as herbivores. Omnivores. Because omnivores eat mostly one type of food, they have many different types of teeth. These animals have incisor in the front of cutting. They also have canines which help them tear up meat. Omnivores have molars in the beak of their mouths to grind up their food. Bears are an example of a big omnivore. These animals eat plants such as berries and nuts. When these food are growing, they will also eat fish in the spring. Bears will hunt animals during any season when they need to eat. Raccoons and pigs are examples of medium-sized omnivores. Animals that eat both animals and plants are called omnivores. This type of animals has the advantage of a wide selection of food to satisfy their hunger and dietary needs. Some scientists call omnivores opportunistic eaters. Who are called opportunistic eaters? The omnivores are opportunistic eaters. This means that they can and will eat almost anything that is around when they are hungry. Omnivores also have the benefit of being able to find food at any time of year because they will eat the food that is available. For example, an omnivore will eat fruits and nuts growing on plants during the summer, and it will also hunt for meat during other seasons of the year. So omnivores are optimistic eaters. many birds and both insects and berries, making them omnivores. Omnivores live in every type of environment, including deserts, forests, water, and even the Arctic. The Arctic ground squirrel will feast on insects and plants to survive. We may observe the omnivores. These are human beings and the chimpanzee, dog, rat, monkey, brown bear, badger, civet, warthog, goatee, skunk, squirrel. These are the animals that eat both animals and plants called omnivores. Sir, can you hear me? Some birds such as hawks and eagles are also carnivores. Snakes are usually carnivores as well. Small carnivores include frogs, birds such as robins and spiders. Carnivores provide an important service in the wild because they help control the population of other animals. If carnivores were not hunting and removing these animals from environments, these animals could overpopulate an area. So carnivores are very, very necessary in the food habit. These are the figures are carnivores, the hunting animals. By observing the food habits, the animals are divided into three groups. Only plant-eating animals, cow, goat, deer, buffalo, etc. Only plant-eating animals, only animals eating animals, lion, tiger, cheetah are the animals. Both eating animals are known as human beings. Dogs and fox are known as omnivores. By observing the all the animals, they are converted into three groups. First one is only the plant-eating animals are cow, goat, deer, etc. Only animals that eat animals, lion, tiger, cheetah, etc. Both eating animals are omnivores animals, human beings, dogs, fox, etc. Both which will eat. Which group of members have an advantage in finding food? Why do you think so? Both eating animals. Which will eat? Both plants and animals have an advantage in finding food because they can eat both plants and animals, so they can find food easily. Could the animals in food group 3 depend only on plants if animals were not available? Why? Yes, they can only depend on plants if all animals are not available. If animals are not available because they can live with eating plants. What happens if all animals eat only plants? If all animals start eating plants, the population of animals will increase on Earth. There will be a huge demand on plants and for forest Cover will be reduced. There will be shortage of food and food chain will get disturbed and there won't be ecological balance. Taking in food. Some small animals that live in water do not move about. They are attached to some solid objects in the water, like skaters. Some of these animals have mouths that are surrounded by tiny hairs. The tiny hairs sweep food particles into the mouth. The food are microorganisms that float in the water. For example, Hydra collects its food by the tiny mouthparts of spirochetes. The Euglena also collects its food. It is a small animal, microorganic animal, and it is also collect most by flagellum. Other animals have tentacles around their mouths. These tentacles push food into the mouth. Many insects like butterflies and moths have a tube-like mouthpart. With that, they suck nectar from flowers. A frog throws out its sticky tongue towards an insect. The insect gets stuck on the frog's tongue, then the frog swallows it. How can the frog will be put out the its tongue, send its tongue and sticky tongue towards the insect and collects the food and send it to its mouth. Small birds catch flying insects with their beak. A hummingbird has a long beak that can get nectar inside a flower. The large hook beak of a parrot can crack nutshells. Some birds have beaks that contain sieve, which strains thinly shelled animals out of the water. Some birds catch their food with their strong, sharp claws. The nectar collects by the its swallow, long beak. Hummingbird collects the food from the flowers with its beak, from the flower, the nectar. When you observe the parrot, it has a short beak and it removes the shell of the grain. Many animals have special kinds of teeth. Some teeth are for biting and tearing, while others are for grinding. Dogs, cats, lions, tigers, and wolves have pointed canines. They use these teeth for ripening and tearing their food to pieces. They use their molars for grinding the meat. Snakes swallow their food whole. When you observe the snakes, swallow do not bite the food, only it swallow the food. They have teeth that curve back toward the throat. They use their teeth to pull the prey back to the throat. Cows, horses, sheep, and giraffe have broad, flat molars. They use the molars to chew and mash plants. Here we observe the grass-eating animals have flattened molars. With the molars, they cut the grass and eat. Pond skaters, an insect which feeds on other insects. Detect ripples produced in water by any other insect trapped on the water surface. They compare the ripples on the opposite side of the pond caused by the legs of the insect struggling to move out, calculate the distance and set out to grab it. Here the scientist will collect his food by grabbing the food. Here are some of animals: hen, cow, dog. Hen collects its food. The body parts used, hen's body parts are used to collect food is beak. The cow's body parts used to collect food is mouth. Dog collects food by tongue and mouth is used to collect its food. The frog collects its food by using its tongue. Snake used its mouth to swallow the food, collects the food and swallow it. Man, mouth part is used to collect the food. Lizard, mouth and tongue is used in the lizard. Vultures, body parts used are beak. Lion, in lion, which body parts are used? Legs, claws, mouth parts are used to collect the food. Hummingbird, which body part used in collecting food? In hummingbird, beak is used to collect the nectar from the flower. We may observe the bull collects its food by using its flattened molars. When you observe, the incisors are very sharp and very strong to tear the flesh compared to the molars. Here the animal that crow, it will be also tear the flesh with the beak and claws. The snake collects its food by using its mouth, but the teeth is not used to collect the food, only it throws inside. The lizard is also collects by using its tongue and mouth parts are used to collect the food. Body parts used examples to collect food. Example, beak used in many birds like hens, duck, crow, woodpecker, eagle, sparrow, pigeon, crane. The body parts used as a tongue in many animals, for example, dog, cat, cow, buffalo, frogs, lizards, lion, tiger. The teeth is one of the body parts. It is also used in many animals like rabbit, squirrel, cat, dog, fishes. The sucker is one of the body parts. It is also used in different animals like leeches, snails, earthworms. Sucker is the body part used in leeches, snails, earthworms to collect the food material. Strong legs with claws, tiger, dog, eagles. The different animals may collect its food. You may find the beak. Crane collects its food by its long beak. The long beak is used to collect its prey. When you observe the woodpecker, its name shows it collects the insects to removing the bark from the plants. The crow, when you observe the crow, is the waste material and dead materials. It is also known as the natural scavenger. What is the natural scavenger? Which bird is known as natural scavenger? The crow is called natural scavengers. Vultures and crows are known as natural scavengers. When you observe pigeon, it is also used with the short beak. The grains will be collected. Tongue is one of the tool to collect its food by the tiger. The tiger collects its food, finding food and eating it. Plants and animals are the main source of food in our surroundings. Like us, animals also depend on these sources of food. Every animal has its own style of getting food. They track down, collect, grab, or hunt, and then use various tools to finally take food into the mouth. Most of animals feed regularly, but first they must locate food to do this. They use a wide range of senses: smell, sight, hearing, taste, and touch. Some animals rely more on one sense than the other, and it can therefore be highly developed in them. What do you think? Let us consider some example to understand this better. What do you think the dog does to find its food? Which sense of the dog do you think is more developed? In dog, the sense of smelling power is more developed. What about the vultures that fly high above in the sky, yet find their food on the ground? Which sense do they mainly use in finding their food? The vision power is more developed in vultures. How do bats find their food in night? In night, the bats send some sounds. By the sounds, their hearing power is more developed in the bats. If we ever go near a pond, observe the pond skaters. Observe how quickly they move from one side of the pond to another side to catch an insect that falls in water. Pond skaters detect ripples produced in water by any other insect trapped on the water surface. They compare the ripples on the opposite side of the pond caused by the legs of the insect struggling to move out, calculate the distance, and set out to grab it. Crows that live in our surroundings usually eat waste and rotten food materials, dead animals, etc. They keep our surroundings clean in this manner, so they are called natural scavengers. Vultures also call so due to the type of food they eat. Getting food without hunting. Some animals get their food without hunting, and some others do not hunt. It is very interesting to watch how a duck catches its food. Ducks also have teeth, but they are not like the teeth of a cow or lion. They are not useful in grinding food. They act as filters to get food from water. Similarly, fish too have teeth, which are used for the same purpose as the as that of dust. How leeches get their food? When we walk on the banks of ponds, canals, etc., we can see different kinds of animals. We can see leeches, snails, earthworms, etc. People in rural they find leeches while raising cattle near water. They find leeches on the skin of animals. Leeches stick on the skin and suck the blood of cattle as well as humans. They have special structures called suckers in their mouth to do this. Do snakes and earthworms also suck something from the ground? The snail can suck its prey because their mouth is like a radula, breaking down their prey and scraping it into the digestible bites. In case of earthworm, as it crawls through the soil, it is sucked inside the mouth of the earthworm. The food enters the mouth. It is sucked into the pharynx, where mucus is separated by the pharyngeal gland. Modes of getting food. Lizard on the wall. Just like snakes, a lizard sticks out its tongue to cast sand particles in the air and then pulls back its tongue and places those particles on the roof of its mouth, where there are special sensory cells. The lizard can use these scent clues to find food or a mate, are to detect enemies. Okay, up to this we complete the lesson. Tomorrow will be conduct the lesson. We are unable to say the food chain. Okay, bye. Thank you.